How's it going?
Once
intro music, Golden Slumbers by the Beatles. Awesome song. Obviously the meaning is up to the listener's interpretation, but what I've always liked about it is it's a reflection on at least to me, of the past. Of you know, there's a line about once there was a way to get back home in the song. In fact, let me see here. I think it's going to come back up. It's a very short song. Hey, here we go. Good lyrics. Good to cut. Anyways. Great album, Abbey Road. It's got the famous picture with the rumors that Paul is dead all abound in it, of them crossing Abbey Road. If you don't know what I'm talking about, you'll just have to do a Google search of Paul is dead, Beatles, and there's all kinds of, all the way from the Magical Mystery Tour all the way out to the White Album, different clues that Paul McCartney had died as a member of the Beatles. There was a big rumor, and had been replaced by somebody else that looked like him. And the Abbey Road record is definitely in the middle of the height of those rumors or clues, and the picture there has a lot to do. It's an interesting, I guess, publicity stunt that the band did, or that they still, I think, to this day, deny. There's all kinds of, I mean, there's just tons of different clues and stuff throughout lots of the Beatles albums, which it's kind of weird that they would have done this as a publicity stunt, because they didn't need it. But at the same time, I guess it was kind of genius as far as it goes with celebrities and musicians and bands and all that other stuff, whether it's good or bad. Most of the time, if people are talking about you, it's publicity, and there's no except for being canceled, which can happen in today's culture, I guess, some there's really not bad publicity. But even Mr. Kanye West is maybe putting that on, changing the narrative on that. We'll see how things work out with his latest. There's some people actually pushing back against that, Elon Musk and Kanye, that it might be changing the narrative on this let's cancel everybody that we don't agree with thing going on, which I hope kind of the pendulum does swing back to the middle. It's getting a little silly that just because you disagree with someone that they are canceled and can't be a member of society anymore. I mean, come on. I thought what made especially progressive people strong and what's the word I'm looking for? One of the major things of that movement, the progressive movement, is being for open speech, accepting all viewpoints, and government not spying on people, no matter who they are, because it's just not right. And all kinds of other things like that. It's been a really weird few years, how a lot of those things have changed. But I continuously optimistic see that that is hopefully swinging back a little bit more to the middle, because I think most people would agree that a lot of those things I just said are not right. Anyways, there's a lot of viewpoints and a lot of idiots out there. But I would rather have the most crazy stuff being posted online as opposed to just taking that person and getting rid of them and canceling it. I mean, it's an insult to not think that we as people can decide for ourselves what media we want to listen to and not listen to, and make our own decisions, informed decisions, as they should be, about what to believe and not believe. I've said this millions of times before. There's, you know, if you believe some of this crazy conspiracy stuff that's going around, you know, shame on you if you're not doing your homework. But at the same time, a lot of that stuff is because it's like calling somebody racist anymore. It's being so abused and used that sometimes when you call someone a conspiracy person now, that's not really true. Or you call somebody a racist, it's not true. It's people using these terms and abusing them, and so they've lost their meaning, and it's a shame, because it shouldn't be like that. And don't get me wrong, these things, there are a lot of nut jobs out there, and there's a lot of racist people and stuff going on, but still, I really think it's not as bad as people want to make it out to be. And just because you and I don't see eye to eye on something doesn't mean we can't exist together, and there's a lot more we have in common than we have probably that we disagree on. Anyways, I'll get off my soapbox about that. I'm going to start this off like I always do, with my positive affirmation drink. Today I'm drinking the zero calorie or low carb Monster, zero sugar. I don't know. It's one of them. I usually drink this one or the white one, because they both are low in sugar. There's like so much other junk out there. There's like 100 different types, brands of these, or flavors or whatever else. These just seem to be the ones that I like. I'm unfortunately drinking way too many of these. I had one of these and two Danish cheesecake Danishes, I think that's what they call them, for breakfast today. Not my typical breakfast at all. I just got done doing an hour of spinning, hopefully to work some of that off. It's horrible food, horrible. I went to Costco. I took somebody to Costco today because I have a membership there, and I was going there mainly to get gas, and we stopped and went in, and she went nuts, bought all kinds of stuff, and a lot of the stuff she gave me, that a lot of it comes in twos. Like, she bought two loaves of bread. If you've been to Costco, you know what I'm talking about. And she gave me some of the junk that she bought, even against my wishes. And like the Danishes she gave me, I actually ate two and threw the other two out, because I'm bad like that. I will, if it's in the house, I'll eat it. So I usually just refrain from buying that kind of stuff. Same thing with potato chips, most crackers and stuff like that. I'll sit down and eat that stuff in one or two sittings, as opposed to going through the work of making dinner or whatever. I try really hard to keep real food in the house and have to prepare meals. I've got some junk, some top ramen and stuff like that for when I'm in a hurry. Eggs, which are quick and easy. Anyways, before I get too far off on diet and all that, so how this works is I do a kind of a tote, what's like a toast, what I call my positive affirmation drink. If you want to join me with your drink of choice, I would really enjoy that. It is my belief that your daily, weekly, monthly, and yearly outlook are what helps create your reality and your happiness in life. Every day we wake up, we have a choice on how to look at the world. And life is short. We only get so many revolutions around the sun in our lifetime before we go on to hopefully the other journey. But it's my belief that we should make the best out of this journey that we can. And having a positive attitude and making the best out of the situation, no matter what it may be, is, in my opinion, one way to do, to make this, to enjoy the journey, to make it the best that you can, to do your best, to be a good person. There's some people that appear to be miserable all the time. I'm sure you may know a person like this, and it just doesn't seem And it seems like it's they make it their job to make everybody else around them miserable. And I try really hard to look at these folks with compassion, because they are obviously going through some things or hurt or whatever the case may be. It can be tough, though. It seems like sometimes no matter what you do, you can't do right sometimes by some people or some situations. But, I think that if you're the best person you can be, hopefully that can help others around you be the best that they can, too. It's the old the Michael Jackson song, right? The man in the mirror, the change starts with you. I really aspire or believe that attitude to a certain degree. Anyways, so how this works, keep putting off this toast or this pot, what I call positive affirmation drink, is on the count of three, I'm going to say attitude is everything, which is my motto, and then take a drink. You're welcome to join me. I promise it will make you feel better, make you more positive, and make you sexier. All right. So if you've got that drink, on the count of three, here we go. 1, 2, 3. Attitude is everything. Very good. All right. Well, I want to keep this, once again, as short as possible. I had a realization today while I was riding my spin bike. I'm getting ready to go through a lot of changes. I'm moving back to Daytona Beach, Florida area. The middle of next month, I start my new job. I'm real excited about that. By the way, I had a couple of options on which area of Florida to move. I could have went to Sarasota area or Daytona Beach. I chose Daytona for a couple of reasons. One is a very personal and embarrassing reason. There is someone I used to date. I'll just say it and get it out of the way. There's someone I used to date there that I really screwed up the relationship. I acted like a fool. I probably wasn't in the best place in my life at the time. And I'm worried about going back there because Sarasota is not that big of a town. And I don't want to act immature around this person, try to go by and see them. It's inevitable that if I stay out there, I would run into them. It's my hope that they're doing the best that they can in their life right now, and that hopefully they're in a healthy relationship with somebody or not, or whatever. I just hope that they're happy. But this person has not. I tried reaching out to them many times. This has been years ago. Since we split up, to try to see about getting back together, and I've been met with really no reply at all. So I don't want to go back and put myself in the position of making their life uncomfortable, or mine either. You know, when you, just like I was talking about with the food, bringing unhealthy food into my house, chips or whatnot, that's one way to resist the temptation, is to not have it around. Well, the same thing I didn't with this situation. So that's one of the major reasons why I decided not to go back there. It's not to say that I wouldn't want something to happen with this person, but at the same time, you cannot, you know, it takes two, the other person's got to be wanting to do that as well, and all indicators that they aren't, so I have to accept that and move on. And work-wise, it's going to be more challenging in Daytona, and those of you that know me, I like a challenge, so it's going to be harder, but I want that. I want to prove my worth to the company and hopefully help them be successful. That's another thing I want to talk about. For whatever reason, I have a tendency to date, hang around, and here lately work for people that, to be honest, I'm too good for. And I know that sounds a little bit arrogant, but for whatever reason, I don't know if it was the way I was raised or something else in my life, I've always undervalued who I am. And it's just, unfortunately, this late in life come to me, the realization of what an asset I am or can be to certain people, organizations, and other people's lives. And for whatever reason, I've gravitated towards people that I don't really need to be around. I've hung out at some places, hung out with some people that I just shouldn't. You know, there's one thing to try to help people. It's another thing to get drugged down by them. And I think that's part of it. I've got a, I really hate bragging or trying to gloat about myself, but I feel like I've got a big heart, and sometimes I will let other people take advantage of that to where it can benefit them but not benefit me, and that's not a healthy relationship. So that's one of my big goals for coming back to Florida, is to find relationships, working in work, professional and personal, that are beneficial to both people. If not, it's not worthwhile for me, or for them, for that matter. It's unhealthy. The second subject I want to get on to is that the feel, the theme of these posts that I've been doing, and what do you call them? I call these amputee casts, but these podcasts, has been very self-centered. And a while back, a couple months ago, an old friend of mine reached out to me who said that they found me on the internet. Well, you know, I don't have Facebook or Instagram or any of that stuff anymore. I got off of that because I got tired of it being so personal and posting so much stuff about myself. And then what did I do? I got on my sites that were supposed to be a resource for other people and posted a bunch of stuff about myself in my situation. So I want to apologize for that. That was never the intent of my blog, of my site, to do that. It was supposed to be a resource to people, to other amputees, so they come and find information. And so I'm going to really focus hard on making these podcasts, these posts in the future, the subject matter more about you, about people who are amputees, whether they've been a new amputee or experienced, that are looking for information about different subjects. My very next post is going to be about insurance, getting a prosthesis without insurance. I'm not going to go into it now because this is already running pretty long, but I will post a post about that. I will post a post. I will put something up about that at my next video posting, whatever. I really want to talk about that subject. I think it's something that can help a lot of people, and I'm going to continue to do that in the future. Don't get me wrong. I'm going to talk about what I do as far as what I like prosthetically and maybe health-wise and stuff like that, but I'm not going to make it so much about me, but about, I'm going to generalize it more and make it about you and about people who are looking for resources and information or advice on what to do and how to cope with, especially being an amputee, and strategies they can use to be successful in their life. So I do apologize for making it so personal. I may get back on some of those other platforms for that. I'm thinking about getting really ambitious and doing some music stuff and all that, but I'm going to try to keep all of that separate from this site and these videos, because that was never the intent for these, and I do apologize for that. It's been a rough, crazy year. I mean, I feel great because I've made some really good changes. This last bike week, it was amazing. I went to Daytona. It's probably the only bike week I've been to where my blood alcohol level actually stayed below the legal limit. My diet has changed over the last 6 months. over the last year, but the last 6 months I've really dialed it in. I feel so much healthier. I'm working out on a regular basis. I'm in a much better spot. Short story, I went into a bar that I used to go to on a regular basis when I was in Daytona, and the bartender there actually remembered me, and she was very hesitant about giving me any shots or anything because of how crazy I was acting before I moved. And I was really upset about that. I said, what are you talking about? I haven't been in here in a year. I can't believe that you're being this way. But she was right. I got nuts before I left. I got really unhealthy. Wasn't in a good place in my mind. It's so good not to be abusing substances anymore, to not be drinking as much, and just to be a little healthier. I feel great. And I kept making posts here about quitting drinking and all that, and I never did it, and then lo and behold, it just happened. Something clicked inside and made that work for me for whatever reason, and I'm glad. It's not to say that I don't think about going out drinking or whatever on a pretty regular basis, but I especially doing shots or other things. Alcohol is a strange substance. It can really affect your judgment. So you got to be careful with it. I'm so glad to, like I said, I feel blessed to be in the, have the health I do, be in the shape that I'm in, and the clarity of mind. I mean, I've seen a lot of friends from playing music and stuff that have just really gone to some bad places and look terrible, or who have died already. And I feel blessed. And I feel like I got a lot to offer still to the world. I'm really looking forward to getting back out into Florida and working and being a positive force for people and for the good side of right and wrong, because I think we need that in this world. Anyways, thank you so much for listening. Promising to flip this script and make this more about you in the future. So please don't give up on me. I see I still get quite a few visitors to the site. I definitely want to make it a lot more accessible though, and more information based instead of just a this is what's going on in my life right now type of thing. That's, yeah, you can go to Instagram or whatever if you want to do that kind of thing. And I'm going to make it a goal to be a good source of info for people and that sort of thing. So here's to the future, and I'm looking forward to continuing to post and my move and all the new exciting changes that are going on. Take care. God bless.